Thank you for listening to episode 19 of the Catholic Servant Podcast, and I'm your host, Alexandra Kubabatu, and this is where we feature faithful individuals in business, ministries, and apostolates who strive to give glory to God in all things while sharing valuable business or work-related tips and inspiring messages. And today, my brothers and sisters, I have an open letter to those persecuted for their Catholic faith. I want to start with a prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My Queen and my Mother, I give myself entirely to you, and to show my devotion to you, I consecrate to you this day my eyes, my ears, my mouth, my heart, my whole being without reserve. Wherefore, good Mother, as I am your own, keep me, guard me as your property and possession. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters who suffer persecution for being faithful Catholics, I'm reaching out to you to let you know that God is with you and you are not alone. We suffer from all forms of hatred, from name-calling to blatant lies being spread about our character. Many around the world suffer physical persecution, such as torture. Then there's psychological persecution with discrimination that includes the loss of job opportunities, workplace or social media bullying, having your website or social media profile shut down. Then we have the spiritual attacks on you and your loved ones. Our Lady warned us about the attack on the family. Then there's political and cultural persecution, particularly for the pro-life community making gains in saving the lives of the most vulnerable. But sometimes the type of persecution that tends to linger is alienation or ridicule or being condescended by our children, our spouses, our mothers, our fathers, our brothers or sisters, for speaking the truth as God requires of us, for courageously living our faith, our Catholic faith, and casting a divide between ourselves and the pop culture. And no, we won't just go with the flow. We were made for battle in the way that Our Lady and her beloved Son have taught us. As it's been said, preach the gospel at all times and use words if necessary. And by the way, St. Francis didn't really say that. And if you do need to use words, remember the verse on 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 1. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. Speaking with love, that's the hard part, but most necessary. We all know even the gentlest and loving telling of truth can incite hatred. So grab your rosary and shield yourself in humility so Our Lady will be quick to guard and guide your precious soul. Also, remember that there is an eternal congregation of saints and angels battling this good fight with efficacious prayers from heaven. Continue with faith, hope, love, and with a heart that's guarded, yet fully open and lifted up to the Lord. You are not forgotten. Your suffering offered to the Lord will not be in vain, and your love will resound throughout eternity, sending love and hugs. Let us pray together, my brothers and sisters. Heavenly Father, you know the exhaustion of my body and the pain in my heart. Lord, you know many times I fail and feel overwhelmed with being persecuted for my Catholic faith. Help me find rest in you and to renew my heart with deeper compassion, love, and patience for those who call me their enemy. Send me the grace to find peace in the calling you have for me at this time, and to always remember that my biggest offense is the shield of humility. Please help me to see that I am enough, even in my brokenness, to be your instrument of peace and justice. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl through the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Saint Michael the Archangel, pray for us. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, have mercy on us. Our Lady of Sorrows, pray for us. Saint Joseph, pray for us. Saint Thomas More, pray for us. Saints Peter and Paul, pray for us. Saint Joan of Arc, pray for us. Saint Jose Sanchez del Rio, pray for us. Our guardian angels, watch over us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dearest Catholic servants, please don't hesitate to let me know your special intention so we can pray for you during our next family rosary. My email address is alexandra@thecatholicservant.com. Please feel free to share this message with someone who may need encouragement at this time. May God bless you.